What's up, Suns Army? Darth Pascal here. Today we are diving into the lore and backstory behind Octane. What connects Octane to the Apex games? What connects him to some of the legends? And where did his legs go? So without further ado, after like 18 cups of coffee and watching that intro over and over and over again, just getting as hype as possible, let's dive in to the most ADD legend out there, Octane. Octavius Silva is one of the youngest legends in the Apex games, at only 24 years old. Octane grew up with a normal, if not very privileged life. Both of his parents were CEOs of Silva Pharmaceuticals. Growing up on the planet of Samatha, he had everything he could ever want, but despite that, he was still bored. So bored that he took up the life of a daredevil, trying to do everything to the absolute max. He wanted to do everything bigger and better than everyone else. He wanted to be faster. So he set out to have the fastest time on the Gauntlet, an extreme sport version of track, I'm guessing. Octane used a grenade to finish the course and was successful in setting the record for the fastest time, but at the cost of his legs. Lying in a hospital bed, discouraged that he may never run again, he begged his close friend, Aegis Shea, aka Lifeline, to move him up the waiting list to get his new legs. Fearing what he would do, she obliged and helped move him up the list and get back on his feet. She invited him to participate with her at the Apex Games. Lifeline knew that the Apex Games would satisfy his need for an adrenaline rush while being able to keep a close eye on her oldest friend. Flash forward a little bit in time, newcomer Loba has enlisted almost every legend to help collect pieces of an artifact to find out more information about Revenant, promising treasure and adventure to all who participate. Even Octane was interested, but after a few missions that weren't quite Octane's style, he was once again bored. So he took matters into his own hands. He went out to find the artifact completely on his own. He was unsuccessful, however. He had fallen, losing lots of blood. It seemed it would be it for Octane. Adventure had finally gotten the best of him. Then, Lifeline came in as his body was failing and saved his life, pulling him out and fixing his wounds. Lifeline was angry at his recklessness, but still felt responsible that she let harm fall on him. At the end of the Legends quest, it revealed information that scared Lifeline and Octane. They might be heading to a new arena on their home planet, in a place called Olympus, home to two people named Darren and Dorado. Just hearing their names shook Octane to his very core. He was frightened and scared to go home. Home to his planet, and even closer to home, his native city of Olympus. And in Olympus waiting for him, two of the only people that ever truly scared Octane. Octane is fun to play as and live out daredevil fantasies and perform crazy trick shots. But Octane's backstory shows us that he truly cares for his friend Lifeline. But despite that care, he is still mostly selfish and chases after the next big thrill, even if his own life is on the line. Thanks for watching. If you're new here, subscribe. If you liked it, drop a like. It's that simple. And comment down below what legend you think we should do next. I'm Darth Pascal, and I'll see you next time.